John Gladden has traveled almost 400 miles for this opportunity.
Particularly, I'm chasing the there's Andromeda galaxy. It's bright as deep space objects go.
That's right. The Baltimore resident has traded his house in the suburbs for two nights in a tent in a field in Virginia's Staunton River State Park. He hopes to realize a dream and snap a photo of a galaxy 2.5 million light years away.
You got to have relatively dark skies, and you have to go through a number of procedures with the camera. It's the hunt that you want to do. That's the challenge. And it's a interesting hobby, but it's technically challenging, and that's what I like about it.
And he's not alone on a star quest. About 120 amateur astronomers are setting up camp at the park for what's become known as the Staunton River Star Party. It's one of the largest gatherings of amateur astronomers on the East Coast. And everyone can point to a defining moment when they became hooked on the heavens. Kendall Nelson was 8 years old. His father brought home a telescope.
I found Saturn and I was hooked. Yep. You know, it's one of them things. It's a garage sale deal, and I'm like, okay. And I enjoyed it. Very much loved it.
And across the field, telescopes come in every conceivable shape and size and optical power and even cost. Some are home-built, many are not, but they've been outfitted with cameras and computers. It's the wonder of the skies that has folks hooked.
What stars are and what they mean, and you know, we have our sun in the sky shining on me now, but there's all different kinds of stars at different ages and different parts of their stellar evolution. It's interesting. And then you can not only see stars, but then you see, you know, nebulae and comets and planets, and you know, the first time you see Saturn, you're kind of hooked on it, and you want to see, well, what else can I see up there in the sky?
And it's easy to get hooked on the heavens, even in the daytime. Matt showed me that. With the right filters on the telescope, you can see sunspots, which are areas of cooler temperatures on the sun's surface.
Whoa! Almost a ring. Oh, wow. That's cool.
Here's a photo of what I saw, and to add to the wow factor, the sun is so far away that the light I looked at through the telescope left the star 8 minutes ago.
That is neat.
It's such a big universe that we can see.
But it's the dark skies that draw star watchers to Staunton River State Park. Eyeing the boost in visitors, the park is marketing its darkness and trying to make it even darker.
We're working with local counties and towns, municipalities to work on their street lighting, trying to get some, you can actually put these reflectors on your street lights so that all the light is directed downward instead of just outward. And that keeps down on light pollution for the surrounding areas. If they were all to do this, and it seems like they're on board and we're working towards that. Once we get this implemented, that'll cut down on a lot of that, and we'll be even more dark than we are now.
As the sun set, the camp comes alive. The telescopes are readied. Venus has risen. Fifth grader Aaron Satko has the planet in his sights.
Does it look like a crescent tonight? Oh, yeah. Wait. Okay, yeah. It's shimmering a lot because it's low down in the sky, so you're looking through a lot of layers of atmosphere right now. It's a great father-son activity. It gets us out to enjoy nature, enjoy God's creation.
The red lights, which let you see at night, snap on. There are two camps of astronomers here, the visual observers, who just want to look, and the imagers, who want a photograph.
Because every day you're learning, you know, and for me, amateur astronomy is a hobby. So do I dwell on it all the time? No. Am I the most versed at it? Absolutely not. There's guys out there that I talk to just blow my mind, and you just listen to discussions of eyepieces or optics and or galaxies and what they know, and you just say, wow, I wish I knew all that. But you come to events like this event here, and this is where you learn.
And here are some of the images captured that night. My thanks to the amateur astronomers whose names are listed. Thank you.
Well, once you realize how the vastness of space is so mind-boggling. There's a galaxy that's 2.5 million light years away. All the stars you see before that is all in our galaxy. It makes you humble. It makes you really humble to realize that we're so small in the cosmos.